Hi, welcome to Numerics Video Blog. I'm your host, Jim Jocko. With me today, Anna Barbashova from the Numerics Client Solutions Group. How you doing, Anna?
Hi, Jim.
A lot of people might know Anna by voice only and on papers from the Numerics webinar series that you've been conducting over the past few months around OIS discounting. So it's great to have you on video. I appreciate your time today. Collateral shortfall and collateral management, clearly in the news. More important now than it has ever been, especially as we think of the announcements this week that some of the dealers are going to be moving to a standardized CSA. However, there's so much optionality in existing CSAs that are going to be on the books for many, many years. Why is the importance of managing cheapest to deliver and building these curves part of the valuation process, why is that so important at this point in time? Mm-hmm.
Well, as you said, there's a lot of optionality embedded in current CSA agreements where they allow to put collateral in cash or treasury bonds or corporate bonds in various currencies. And therefore, it's really important for the bank or for the firm to identify which will be the cheapest one to post, because by minimizing the funding rates that they're earning on collateral, they will maximize their return and they will come back to their front office books. So of course, the most important thing is profit.
So essentially, it's changing the way valuations are done. It's not just a pre-trade discovery of what is the cheapest to deliver over time, but it's almost intrinsic to the valuation process and something that is recalculated daily. Is that correct?
Well, yeah. I mean, you will have almost unique CSA agreement for each of the trades. Therefore, you will need to identify the cheapest collateral possible for each of those trades every day over the time, because you need to figure out through the time if you need to switch that collateral, right? If the cheapest will be a different one.
So I know we talked a lot about OIS discounting and the complexity.
Yeah.
And thinking in terms of building the CTD curves themselves, how complex is even the most simplistic OTC evaluation?
Well, we all know before the crisis we had just one LIBOR curve and we would use that for projection and discounting. But with the divergence of the rates between the LIBOR and OIS, we need to use the OIS curve right now for discounting. And therefore, let's take a simple example. You have a collateral. The CSA agreement that allows you to post collateral in cash in three different currencies. That means that you need to build the curves for each of those currencies, the OIS curves, then when you need to build projection curves, the cross-currency curves, and et cetera, et cetera. So you end up somewhat around 15 curves to build just for the three currencies cash collateral.
So the complexity is almost overwhelming in terms of the management. But let me ask you one question, and you said this in the webinar that we were talking the other day. Cheapest to deliver is not always optimal. Can you talk about that a little bit in terms of collateral management?
Well, I mean, you need to look at considering cheapest to deliver and optimizing what assets you have in your firm and what how do you want them to allocate to different trades, right? So, say for example. You compute your cheapest to deliver curve and you identify which one will be the cheapest collateral to post, but what if you don't have it in your pool of assets? That means that you need to go outside and source it or go and get it somehow, right? But what if it's more expensive than actually taking the next cheapest to deliver collateral that you have in your assets and post that one instead? So saying that, it's really important for the firm to have the collateral management system that will have rules and requirements on top of identifying which one is cheapest to deliver as well.
Well, Anna, thank you so much for demystifying some of the issues in the marketplace. And for those interested, slides from Anna's webinar earlier this week are available upon request. And follow the debate, because clearly we're not done talking about this. And follow along at nxanalytics.com, on Twitter, as well as our blog on numerics.com. Anna, thank you so much.
Thank you very much,
Jim. And we'll see you next time.